They say that the ocean is big. I wouldn't know. For me, it's always ended at the horizon, where the water meets the fog. I wish I could see what's beyond that line, beyond our island and the plaza. Grandma says that this is our haven, that the lighthouse keeps us safe. But a part of me wants more. It's hard to imagine that this was a different world once. That you could open your door, step outside, and just walk wherever you wanted to go. But that was before the fog. Before the city sank. Before the dirty paws showed up and took everything away from us. We still have a spectacular sunrise, though. I guess the paws couldn't find a way to deprive us of that.
Ahoy, ladies!
Ladies, my bub. Things that need fixing, I presume.
Yeah. Thing for Ursula over at the Sleepy Triplets. A leaking capacitor and some. They said you'd know.
Humph! It's broken again? How does she manage? In my day, we knew how to care for our things.
All right, Sigrid. There's some crab in the basket, too.
Hello, Mr. Bane.
Don't you have somewhere to be, Bane? We have work to do.
Should be on my way. Fog's closing in. By the way, Doris, have you, talked to anyone lately?
I never talk to anyone now, do I?
They say the dirty paws have been seen by the plaza. Haven't spotted them myself, but...
Is this your idea of a joke?
Wish it was. Just be careful, will you?
I could look after myself before you were even born, Bane. Now scram! The air seems absolutely saturated with gloom. We need more sparks if we plan to hold that fog back.
I'm on it.
Remember, no fiddling with your hands. Only use the net, or...
Or they will burn my hands just as they always did Grandpa's. It's not my first time, Granny.
You can't live on old marriage, Shrimpy. I tell you that. Now, what are you waiting for?
Saw some sparks gathering on the beach earlier. Better check the fountain and Grandpa's memorial as well.
Got it.
Always some that escape the lighthouse storage, too.
Oh, we found one.
Give it a good whack. That should lead the... power straight into your battery.
It's like she thinks I've never done this before.
Lighthouse done. Sparks, the fog is really close today.
There must be a reason. I'll take Anita and go investigate. We're done.
I thought you weren't gonna take her out before she's repainted.
Necessity knows no law, Siggy.
By the fountain.
You didn't climb it, did you? That damages the stone finish.
Huh?
Ah, never mind. Just trouble Iris used to cause as a kid.
Mom? Did she play here a lot?
Sigrid, I don't have time for chit-chat. Go get those sparks.
Found the ones by the memorial. Hey, Grandma, why don't we have a stone for Mom?
Stones are for the dead.
But she's been gone for so...
Now what's with you today? Less talking, more spark collecting.
Huh? think.
You're not going close to the water, are you?
Just to get the sparks. I wasn't...
You know what can happen in those waters. There's a reason people don't go swimming, you know. More than a few feet down and...
I know.
Ah, that should do it. With that fog coming, we sure need all the power we can get.
Grandma? What was that about the dirty paws?
I wish you'd never have to live in a world where that scum still existed.
But are they really back?
If they are, we better be ready to batten down the hatches. I don't like the look of that. The lighthouse beams should have pushed it away already. Why won't it?
Grandma! Mr. Vane!
Sigrid! Sigrid, take cover! Oh, this is not good. Not good at all. If this is what the paws are up to, then... You look all pale, girl.
Oh, it's just... there's something...
Is it Anita? Did she capsize?
It's not the boat. Just come see.
Stay back, child! I'll get the harpoon.
No, it's not dangerous. It helped me save you.
Helped you?
Yeah, like... Just watch.
Sigrid, are you out of your mind?
We need more sparks, Grandma. I can go get them.
Absolutely not!
It won't hurt me, I promise. And technically, I'm not in the water, I'm just on it. We don't have a choice.
Oh, have it your way, girl. but don't get used to it.
Sweet mackerel. I wonder what happened to Bane. Tread carefully.
What are you even? I mean, you came at the same time as those monsters. From where?
A bunch of sparklings over here.
Those little sticklebacks won't work for machinery like this. Only good for pocket change. Done on your end, Sigs?
Not quite, so don't buy green bananas.
What's that? Bananas? Why would I want bananas?
It means we shouldn't plan too far ahead.
Do you even know what a banana is?
Just something I heard Bane say once. Forget it.
What's the matter with you, rambling about fruit? Are you quite all right? Well, better get this mess we're in straightened out before you go bananas. Thank you.
Pete, now what?
We'll get your stats so we can fill up the tank. Girl, just get on the boat.
Grandma, it's harmless. I promise.
I don't care if it's harmless. Ocean, Sigrid! It's not normal. Just get up on deck and...
Did you see Mom in that gloom?
I told you to...
I heard you say your name.
If you say one more word while standing on that thing...
Sometimes I just wish that Granny would accept that things have changed. This is what we're stuck with, right? Some days it's not all that bad. Crab to eat, wings to watch. I'm just saying, we might as well make the most of it. Not Granny, oh no. Everything worth doing was apparently done better back in the good old days. She just keeps rubbing it in, you know? When we had the dandelion, before the war. When your grandfather was still alive, blah, blah, blah. The war happened. Grandpa is dead. Sometimes she makes me feel like my future is already in the past.
By the mother of Sparks! It's really them.
What is that?
The flying barge. The Dirty Paw's trump card during the war. We'll discuss that seal of yours more later. Time to speed up.
Thank you. Thank you.
we're some kind of sea creature? When I was a kid, I always wanted a pet. I tried keeping an eel in a barrel once. Freaked Grandma right out of her socks. She was all like, "Eels are no pets! Eels are meals!" Stone guy.
That guy is Dr. Thelonious. I sure hope I've taught you well enough to know about him.
Oh, of course. He discovered Weave Rock.
And its uses, mind you. His work turned a small fishing village into a metropolis.
How sad that his life's work ended up like this.
Thank you.
Oh. Ah.
Me for an oyster. It worked! Quick, let's get going.
I'll catch up to you. Oh, and I met the mayor's mother.
Cordelia? Well, she and her husband ran the Dandelion. Worked closely with them for years. The Rigfield drills at work used to be a sight to behold, bringing up Weave Rock day and night. We heard their thumping all the way to the plaza, like a rhythmic lullaby.
How does it work? How did you get the sparks out of the Weave Rock?
It's a complicated process, dear. Simply put, the Weave Rock was fed into an untangler. Sparks and gloom were carefully separated, and then the sparks went right into the belly of the Dandelion, providing the whole city with energy.
What about the gloom?
Oh, we got rid of that. The gloom kept the spark safe underground, but then it was superfluous. No use for the shell once you've cracked the egg. Of course, when those blasted paws blew up the Dandelion, all the gloom still in the reservoirs ended up all over Strandville. And now it seems that lowlife found a way to weaponize it. Shrimps and lobsters, what is happening here?
Those towers are huge and kind of creepy.
Creepy? Ah, they're just machines built to keep this city running.
They're just so intimidating.
They are, aren't they?
Again, are they following us? What are they spraying?
Nothing you should get close to, that's for sure. Whatever the mayor is doing here, it seems to have sparked their interest. Let's hurry.
Potions! What a... You're the one who... Oh. I am in your debt, miss. They took us completely by surprise.
They?
The dirty paws, dear. Back yet again. Sprayed that horrid gas all over us. Must be how they control the gloom. It seems our work here is even more urgent than we thought.
You're Mr. Clout, then? They worry about you back at the plaza. Asked us to check if you're okay.
Oh, very sweet of them. And I'm quite all right, thank you. But as their mayor, I simply must take some risks. The people of Strandville come first, not me. Oh, Andy.
Yes, sir.
Where are the others?
I'm sorry, sir. It seems like they're all gone.
What a shame. They were brave men.
So this is where you're hiding, Clemens. You idiots started the drills?
Difficult times mean difficult choices, Doris.
But drilling for Weavrock in this day and age? And with no experience at that, the repercussions
we
could be—
We have no choice. Everyone who used to have experience is long gone. My dear Doris, do you remember what Strandville used to be? The avenues of the plaza. The orchids growing in the night orchard.
Only fools linger in the past, I always say.
Indeed. We cannot dwell in bygone days, but it would be foolish not to learn from them. You know as well as I what the Paws are capable of, and what they took away from us. We must protect our young.
So what do you plan to do?
Shoot that dirty Paws out of the sky once and for all. We're building a weapon.
A weapon?
Powered by sparks. How does it work?
Are you interested in helping? I wanted to ask you, but people kept saying that you haven't had much interest in the outside world ever since...
I'm interested in protecting my home. Now show me those blueprints.
Oh, but of course. Andy?
Not good enough.
What do you mean?
What I said. It's not good enough. What does this do?
It, well...
Does this mean you'll join our team, Doris? We sure could use your expertise.
I'd even go as far as to say you couldn't do without it. I'll take these.
Probably just something to adjust.
Granny, look!
What on earth?
Of course! That behemoth of theirs! It's messing with the drills! Sigrid, get to the emergency switch! Shut this down before things get worse!
It won't budge!
Oh, the drills must be set to manual overload! The relief valves are all the way up on the rigs! There's no way we'll get to them! This is what happens when you meddle with things you don't know anything about!
Wait, I think I can see a way up there!
You completely lost it? Ziggy, we need to get out of here!
What if it follows us to the plaza? I have to do this!
Sigrid, come back!
I'm doing this. can do it!
Question is, what happens when they're back?
It's not just the gloom. That spray, it controls those monsters as well. That's horrifying.
If you had been around during the war, then you would have known true horror. We won't let this stop us. Let's head back to Plaza. Doris told me you're in need of some sparks.
Mom used to sing to me when I woke up with nightmares.
Thank you.
Oh.
Oh.
Progress, Siggy?
I'm about halfway between home and the plaza.
Oh, by the old central station, then?
Where? All I see is water.
Oh, probably right under your feet. Too deep down for you to see.
Was it like a station for sparks or something?
No, Shrimpy. For travelers. A busy place. Trains coming and leaving. People hurrying to get their tickets. And a bakery with lovely armchairs called the Blue Sky Cafe. Serve the best bagels in town.
What did bagels taste like?
Better than crab, I can tell you that much.
Thank you.
wrong with the last relay?
Oh, that thing always gets the hiccups. Reboot it and it should be fine. Control board's in the greenhouse.
Hey, Mom. Rough day today. I met a new friend. See if that did the trick. One night when I was a kid, Grandma had a drink and let me stay up late. Then she started telling me about when Strandville sank. It was just 2 days after Grandpa's death. Granny was upset and wanted to join the fight, but there was no one else to watch over Mom. So they took cover in Grandpa's greenhouse. They sat in there looking through his hundreds and hundreds of notes and drawings when something just cracked. Granny said that it sounded like the earth broke in two. They must have been so scared.
Triplets aren't too far. You should be able to spot them once you've passed the old cidery.
What's a cidery?
Your mother actually worked there for a couple of summers before she... They pressed apples from the Kipson farm. Made the best cider around here. A sweetness that set your mouth a-tingling.
Apples? Are those the orange ones?
No, Shrimpy. That's an orange.
So what color?
Doesn't matter. We ain't going to eat one again anyway.
I can make out the triplets ahead. Didn't you and Grandpa used to live there?
We did.
Is that where you met?
No, but it's where we had our first date. He was so nervous, the poor man.
But he dared to ask you out.
I asked him out, dear girl. Without me, we wouldn't even have gotten to first base.
Grandma!
What? That's how it was.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Ask you something?
If you must.
When you were young, before the war and everything, what were your favorite things to do?
Well, what does it matter?
I'm curious, that's all.
Well, if you must know, let's see. I strolled in parks, dined at restaurants, threw parties, visited museums, stayed late at the office, went fishing.
You went fishing for fun?
Oh, it was all different then. We didn't have to worry about being hungry or cold. The dandelion took care of all that. We used our knowledge to give ourselves more leisure time. No time for that anymore, though. Back to work.
Thank you. Are you troubled?
Oh, don't scare it away. Of course I'm troubled. Who's asking?
I'm Sigrid. Ursula said I should talk to you while she went to help out with the baby and all.
Oh, so Adrienne's little one is coming?
Uh-huh. They just shooed me away. You think they'll manage?
Ursula served as a combat medic during the war. She can deliver a baby with one hand tied behind her back. And her eyes closed. The bait! Oh, not again! Choo, you stupid creature!
What are you doing?
Ooh, there's a shadow around. Haven't seen one for years. I'm trying to make contact.
You're studying the shadows?
Ever since I was a little kid, magnificent creatures.
So, what are they exactly?
Oh, they're elusive, kid, that's what they are. Amphibians, according to some. Otherworldly beings, according to others.
My grandma says there's a perfectly natural explanation for everything. We just haven't found them all yet.
The Whistlers say they are souls seeking rest.
The Whistlers?
You probably know them as Dirty Paws. They regard the shadows as messengers from other dimensions. If a shadow seeks you out, it has something to tell you about yourself. Ah, but it seems I know myself inside and out. No shadows coming to me. Only me chasing after them. First, I thought they were attracted to all kinds of mollusks, but... Then I discovered they are drawn to this particular form. The Whistlers make amulets in this shape. They believe it means luck.
Like this?
How did you get that?
Well,
What's inside?
Inside?
They open up, like a little box.
A seed. It is beautiful.
Marvelous. How did you get it? Found it? It stole it?
I didn't steal it. The shadow gave it to me.
Holy mother of all sparks, it's a... I don't believe it. Can I touch it?
You can try. It's okay. He's okay.
She made it there just in time. The baby's already here. They want me to send you there.
Me? I guess I'd better go then. It was nice talking to you.
Indeed it was, Sigrid. Would you come see me again? I can't wait to learn more about your beautiful, wonderful friend.
Thank you.
so crunchy. They still had them when Mom was my age. I'm sure she used to climb to the top of the tree to find the best ones. Not that I wouldn't know about stuff like that. She might not have even been a nice person. Maybe that's why Grandma won't talk about her. I do remember how safe I felt when she held me, though.
Yeah.
Can't believe we're going to Candle Hill.
Oh, nothing to fuss about, Shrimpy. They're just people like you and me. Maybe a bit more crude. More mauls and hammers than knives and forks. Oh, the foreman of the Dandelion was the best mechanic I had ever met. He knew that plant like his own pocket. He would knock on the pipes with his wrench, put his ear to the metal and listen, and then say something like, "There, there, love, it's just a hiccup. That's all. Daddy'll treat you right away." And so he'd calibrate the pressure or grease some cogwheels, and she'd be running as smoothly as ever.
Will we meet him? The foreman?
Oh, he kicked the bucket years ago. But I'm hoping to talk to his son. He was just a scamp back then, but a gifted scamp indeed. If he can't build our weapon, nobody can.
Why is it called Candle Hill?
The furnaces there used to burn at night. You could see them from far off, like lit candle wicks. Shrimps and lobsters, this is a dead end! We need to find a way to break through. Did you talk to someone? What did you find out?
Apparently the generator that powers the torches is shut down.
Oh, well, that's an easy fix. I can even see it from here. Let's go!
Thank you.
back. Nothing. The torches must be filled with gloom. I'll need you to play chimney sweep here, Siggy. Unclogging them should solve the problem. Cause for celebration yet. Let's find another one.
No rest for the wicked.
Border Striders, be on your guard.
Come on.
Huh.
And get through quickly before we draw attention to ourselves. The Hill crew don't like visitors. My, my. Seems like they're throwing us a welcome party.
Is that Clout's ship?
How did he get here before us? Oh, these folks are not easy to deal with. Last thing we need is Clout annoying them even more.
Now, look here. I'm the mayor of Strandville. You can't deny me passage.
You shove your titles where the sun doesn't shine. Now beat it, or we'll melt you down and grease the cogwheels with you.
No use. He's thin as a rake.
Ah, Doris. Right on time. Will you please explain to this noble troop that I come in peace and with good intentions?
I need a word with little Cassius. I have an important job for him.
Cassius doesn't work for stuck-ups. Now get lost, all of you. Scram.
For Sparks, save us from our sins.
Thank you.
barbecue.
Action, lass. Since at least one of you can do more than talk, we'll grant your wish. Follow us.
Who's that?
That's little Cassius, the foreman's son.
Little Cassius?
He's much smaller than his older brother. Now, you let me do the talking.
Well, I'll be damned. Mrs. Skagorat, going slumming, are you?
You never liked me, Cassius, I know that. But now is not the time for old grudges. Can you make this?
Of course I can, but why should I?
Because you and your team are the best builders around here.
That is correct, Mrs. Skagorat. And if you people had thought of that sooner, when our wages were cut and our working conditions were toughened, we might have wanted to offer you our skills now.
But you didn't, did you?
Look, we don't have time for petty quarrels about who owes what to whom. The paws are upon us.
The paws? Oh, she's just trying to trick us into helping her.
No, it's true. Their airship is what brought the gloom here. They control it. We've seen it with our own eyes, right, Grandma?
Yes, we've seen it. They want to destroy us, Cassius. They must be stopped.
We could get the material we need, if we decide to help you, that is. From the wrecks at Needleprick Peaks.
That's really far away. The lighthouse will never be strong enough to push the fog away from there.
You're the one that fought off that snake, am I right?
Yes, Mr. Pirate. I mean, yes, sir.
Well done, girl. And you are quite right about the fog, too. But we have our methods.
Methods?
You know, pirates gotta get the job done, even if there's a little fog around. We've got spark cannons on our best boats. Or on our best pirate ships, I should probably say. Problem is, that nasty serpent flung away all three of them, along with their crew. Help us find them, and we'll help you build your weapon. Do we have a deal, young lady?
We have a deal.
Oh. Oh.
Oh. Ah. Oh.
You're not from around here, are you?
No, I live at the Night Orchard.
Old Botanical Garden, eh? Did some work there with my dad. Watering systems, mostly. Boy, the man in charge of the garden sure knew a lot about plants.
Are you talking about John Skagerrak?
That's the one. How did you... Oh, my. You're that little blue-haired squirt who always got pricked by the rose thorns. You're Iris Sigrid.
You knew my mom?
I did. Thought she was a self-centered little brat.
Oh.
There's more to that story. I'll get to it once I'm done greasing the engine.
One ship coming your way, Peppy.
Hunky dory.
So, that story about my mom?
Oh, right. I met her during my activist years when we campaigned together.
What did you campaign for?
For the dandelion to be shut down. The workers told some worrying stories, my mom included, about how they were treated, about the side effects of the spark extraction. But people didn't listen, so we tried to make them.
Did it work?
What do you think? Better get back to this. Talk later.
No?
You mentioned you didn't like Mom?
That's right. I wrote her off as a privileged rascal looking for attention. Your grandmother was a higher-up at the Dandelion, after all. But with time, I had to admit to myself that she just cared. It's a hard thing to do to change your mind about someone. I'm glad I was brave enough to do it. She became one of my closest friends.
I'm glad to hear she had that. Friends. Another one incoming.
I'm ready. Come join us as soon as you have enough sparks, will you? Nice work. And Sigrid, I'm sorry about whatever happened to Iris. You have my condolences.
Thank you, Peppy. And thanks for sharing your story.
Happy to, kiddo.
not so fond of strangers, unfortunately.
Yeah, I can relate to that. I mean, newcomers rarely mean anything good around here.
They don't?
No one from the outside ever gave a dab about the Hill Crew. Only came around when they needed us.
You mean, like us?
Yeah, I guess. But who gave something back? Chasing off that snake. After the war, people who used to make us work for peanuts at the Dandelion just came pouring in. But this time, they didn't even have peanuts to offer. So we turned them down, decided to keep to ourselves. It made them real mad.
Wait, this must have been way before you were born.
Well, unlike all the hill folks who fought in the war, stormies don't die.
Watch out!
The rocks over there.
That, my friend, is the Needleprick Memorial. A small token of gratitude to those who fought against the Dirty Paws and didn't make it back.
Oh, who built it?
Don't know. Maybe one person. Maybe 100. One day it was just there, and people kept adding to it. At least until this area got too gloomed up to be safe. It's mostly stones and scrap parts from the area, but they're placed with love.
Grandma? Is this where Grandpa died? Granny?
We used to go to the Pine Forest here before the war, you know. Every fall, me and John to pick chanterelles. I always made him cover his eyes for the last part of the way. It was my secret mushroom place, you see, and he wasn't very good at keeping secrets. He would have slipped and told someone if they asked, I'm sure of it. And now, he sleeps here. On a bed of chanterelles.
Such unnecessary evil. We can't let this happen again.
All right. Let's hope this works. This is where the final battle against the Dirty Paws took place. He paid a heavy price, but we finally took them down.
Here we go again. Yeah, He would know where we could find a spark reactor. One of those wrecks gotta have one in working condition.
He's not gonna like this. Not fond of visits, that man. Especially not impromptu ones.
I brought a box of his favorite tea leaves. Hopefully enough for the trade.
What Trevold said about the Dirty Paws, about the Whistlers, I've never even heard that name. Who are they?
To get that poor sod out of there. Yeah.
What's the matter? You look like you've seen a ghost.
The Striders! I couldn't hold them back. And then the Dirty Paws showed up.
The Whistlers.
Yeah, the Whistlers. Anyway, I was sure they would kill me. But they didn't. Actually, I think they tried to...
help you?
Yeah.
You know, all those stories you've been fed are not to be trusted.
How do you know?
Because I am one of those Dirty Paws you're also afraid of. Although I prefer to be called by our rightful name. Care for a cup? That beloved dandelion of yours spat its poison into the sea. Eventually, it reached our lands. Big, nasty blobs that crawled onto our fields and destroyed our crops. We sent message after message to make you understand the damage you were causing, but you wouldn't listen. So eventually, we took matters into our own hands.
What did you do?
We realized we had to stop the gloom ourselves by sabotaging the Dandelion's main conduit. Our boat got hit just after midnight. Three of us were killed immediately, and one lived long enough to say his prayers. I was crying like a babe, but having no wound severe enough to stop me, I kept going. Just before dawn, I reached my target. It was all up to me now. Our scientists had devised a fluid that was meant to drip into the heart of the Dandelion and stop the machinery from running. Our mission was to pump it into one of the central vents, and that's what I did. I pumped the fluid in, plugged the vent, and I left. I didn't look back at first. The only thing I could think of was getting away. But then, when I turned my head, the entire thing had turned into a monster. Gloom shooting out like fountains of black saliva. I remember thinking of hundred-armed octopuses and giant spiders, mythological creatures from my childhood stories. Then came a deafening thunder. The whole thing started to burst. Well, I guess you know the rest.
The ground cracked, the ocean roared, and Strandville was lost in the deep.
After what I caused, I couldn't bear to face anyone. So I settled here.
How did you survive the explosion?
All I know is that I passed out. When I woke up, the sea was calm. But the city was gone. And the people. All we wanted was to put an end to our misery. You understand? I followed the instructions, but it didn't work out. It didn't... Sweet mother of sparks, I should have died with the others.
You tried to save your people. You didn't know this would happen.
You're very kind, just like your mother.
My mother?
She was my friend, the bravest person I ever met. She listened to us, even after the flood. She believed me when I told her that we never meant any harm. She even wanted to help me put things right, so we set out to try and fix the damage I'd caused. But we never... She never... She was investigating methods to change the behavior of the gloom. One day she came to my hideout, looking for clues, as she put it. I told her to get lost. She wasn't easily scared. Like mother, like kid, I guess. She had been breeding flowers, you see. Some kind of modified version of the Nightweaver. An herb we grow back home. She had learned that its roots could bind the gloom back into the weave rock and stop it from spreading. She wanted me to take her to the pipe that started the rupture. Her idea was to pour some spark-induced Nightweaver seeds into the central vent and turned the Dandelion into a sort of mending machine. Don't ask me about the science. That was her forte.
So you went back there?
Yes, child. She even made us go inside. She said it was crucial. I refused at first, but your mother was a very convincing woman. And I know you won't believe me when I tell you this, but it was as though the gloom felt threatened by us. Your mother fought for her life. I lost my right leg trying to save her, and I'd gladly give my left too, if that could bring her back. Since then, the gloom has kept spreading, like the plague it is.
Is there nothing left to do?
The airship manages to fight it off to some extent, using spores from the Nightweaver. But we have nowhere near what would be needed to fight it off forever.
What about this?
By all sparks, where did you get that? We have to get you to the airship. You have to show them!
The airship! They're gonna shoot it down!
What? Who?
That machine Cassius was talking about. It's a spark weapon to shoot down the Whistler's barge.
Oh, those fools! May the gloom drown them! Curse all of them and their trigger-happy fingers! They're nothing but a bunch of short-sighted idiots! You must stop them, do you understand? Do whatever it takes to keep those morons from firing. Then you have to find Moira. Just follow the barge.
Moira?
The Whistler's leader. She's the only one who can make use of that seed. Now go!
Came flying, and I thought I was gonna die, but Granny, they saved me. They sprayed something, and then there were flowers everywhere, and Rufus said that...
That bum at Needlebrick? Siggy, I don't have time for this. Just hurry up and come home.
Promise you won't do anything more until I'm there.
You're breaking up. Just vamoose on back now, will ya?
Gran? Granny?
Ha!
blowtorch, please. Now, what's taking that girl so long? She knows I'm not fond of waiting.
Stop! Stop!
Oh, Sigrid. Nice to see that you made it back safely.
The paws don't control the gloom. They make it flower.
Make it flower? What are you rambling on about?
Grandma, I know what happened to Mom.
She died trying to save us.
The paws.
No, you don't understand. She and Rufus wanted to stop the gloom from spreading. They tried to make it into the dandelion, but the gloom got her. He tried to save her, but...
You have a kind heart, Siggy. But you must stop believing everything people tell you. You are just like your mother in that respect. And if you think I'll let us all meet our maker because of the words of some driveling bum, you are gravely mistaken.
But he...
Even if he was telling the truth, your mother wouldn't have been in any danger if she had kept away from him in the first place.
What gives you the right to always judge people like that? They were trying to save us!
Sigrid, Sigrid. We all understand you're upset. All this stress would get the better of anyone. And you're just a kid. No wonder you've lost your head. Now, why don't you go have a lie down and let us take care of things?
Don't touch me!
Manners, young lady. I only want to help.
You want to destroy! That's what you want! That's what all of you want! Gloom, you!
Shrimps! Shrimpy!
Well, you know how teenagers are, Doris. I wasn't all that easy myself, was I? Leave her. She just needs to walk it off. And we have very important things to attend to.
And you fire at me.
Tell me you're joking. Have you lost your wits? You crazy, stubborn, disobedient. Nobody does anything until I give the order. Is that clear? Stay where you are, Sigrid. I'm coming to get you.
This island, the barge is just above it, and it's... Grandma, there are flowers here. I think I see apples.
No. No, that's not possible. Are you sure?
It's just like the stories you told me. I never thought I...
Sigrid, my dear. You are brave. I give you that. But we simply cannot conform our actions to a child's foolish whims. I am in your debt for helping us come such a long way. But now, it's time to finish what we've started. I am truly sorry, child.
No! Don't shoot!
I have to, Sigrid. It is my duty to do so. Our people want this, and I will not be stopped. The best you can do is try and save yourself.
3, 4, 5. Oh, thank the sparks you're all here. Plus one extra, it seems. Are you a Stranvillian?
I am, but I didn't want this. This wasn't the plan. I tried to stop them.
Oh, so this is how it ends. Stranville, destroying everything for good.
Are you Moira? I was told to come see you. I want to put things right.
There's nothing you can do, girl. Take my advice and go home while it still exists. A Nightweaver's seed? But it's so big.
It's been modified. My mother invented the technique. I was told you may know how to use it.
Well, if it has all the right qualities. But if there is only one, I don't think we
can... If you touch her, you're dead! You hear me? Take your dirty paws off my girl!
Who is that?
Put that away, Grandma!
I'm not letting them have you too! I have to!
The only thing you have to do right now is shut up for a while!
Sigrid,
I tried to tell you before! You wouldn't listen then, but you will listen now! To me and to Moira!
Moira? The Moira?
The very same. And on that ship was our last chance to keep the gloom away until your granddaughter came along.
Sigrid? How is she involved in all this? She shouldn't...
We're using a plant called Nightweaver. Its roots have the ability to tie down gloom. We've been shooting out spores from our airship day and night since that great wave came. But it barely kept the gloom from taking over. And now some geniuses decided to shoot that very ship down.
You're blaming us for trying to defend ourselves? Your people attacked us! You declared war on us!
You think we wanted war? You gave us no choice.
Well, why didn't you just talk to us about-
There's no point in talking if no one will listen. We tried talking to you, both before and after the war. We tried sending messages, we tried sending messengers, and you repeatedly chose not to listen. Too high up on your pedestals with your riches to care about anyone below you. You ripped up the ground we walk on with your cursed drills and sent your own city into the deep.
Well, it takes two to tango, my late husband always said. You blew up the dandelion. Before that, the city was...
I'm sure there was a time for talking, but that time is not now. You're not gonna fight the gloom off by quarreling. Mom used to have this. Did you know that? It's a seed from the Nightweaver. Moira says we might be able to use it.
Iris? Why did she have
There's no time to explain. Right now, you just have to trust us. You have to trust me.
So you're saying that this seed could eliminate the gloom?
It has the right properties. But one is not enough, I'm afraid.
How does it work?
It's no ordinary seed. It's infused with sparks. That's what Rufus told me. Mom invented the technique.
Well, how about we boost it some more? After all, we do have a spark cannon.
Rufus and Mom tried to take the seeds into the dandelion. They wanted to spread them through the gloom pipes, tried to make it inside through one of them.
Well, I'd rather try something that fails than nothing at all. I think I know the place he referred to. I'll show you the way.
Cassius, recharge the cannon. We have some planting to do.
We have some what to do?
Just start recharging and keep Cloud out of action.
My pleasure, Doris. My pleasure.
All right. Now would you help me get to that pipe?
Sure brings back. memories.
You've done it?
As long as my back would let me. A while longer, to be honest. But they shouldn't be here in our world. When Strandville drilled for Weave Rock year after year, the Earth's mantle cracked, and the rifts went all the way down to their domain. And if we'd...
So, a shadow came to you, too?
Yes. My oldest daughter. We lost her during the war. When the shadow came around, I just knew it was her. You do too, right, Sigrid? You know who has come to you.
I think so. I just couldn't believe it. But it feels like her.
Wait, are you saying that thing is my daughter?
A shadow of your daughter, at least. A body for a soul who needs to make contact.
This is it. This is the vent? This is where I was...
Thank you.
found another way in. I'm coming after you.
Spark, huh?
It's done.
Deep breaths, my darling. Waves are crashing. We are still far from shore. Know that I've got you.
She's at peace now, don't you think? What's the matter with Anita?
Easy, Doris. Nothing's wrong with her. I just thought it rude to leave an old lady in distress.
I have a feeling that particular lady knows how to take care of herself.
We did it, y'all! We spark and did it! Whoa, look at these weeds!
Solid stuff. I've never walked on ground that wasn't rock or sand.
You did well, all of you. Eventually. And without you, my dear girl, we never would have made it.
I saw right away that she was made of the right stuff.
Bravest little pirate there ever was. Isn't she, Doris?
Sigrid, you've done such... Why can't I just do this?
Grandma,
No, I have to do this. When Iris was a kid, John always took care of the mushy stuff. But when he wasn't around anymore and we lost Iris, when it was just you and me, I didn't know how to handle my own feelings, much less yours. I put a roof over your head, fried some herring for dinner, and wiped your nose. But the rest... I just couldn't... I'm so sorry, Shrimpy.
You didn't only feed me. You taught me how to use a wrench. And a hammer. And a blowtorch.
Not sure you can say you've learned to use something when you've almost burned the house down with it a few weeks ago.
You might be right about that.
I guess we'll have to keep practicing. Both that and the mushy stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, that sounds nice.
So, what do we do now that we won?
This isn't a victory. It's a second chance.
The girl is right. This is where the real work begins. We have ground to walk upon, but we need to learn how to cultivate it without depleting it. The rifts are sealed, but we still have to get rid of the rest of that wretched gloom.
How long will it take to fix this? When will everything be back to normal?
There's no fixed, dear. And I don't think any one of us knows what normal is anymore. It's a lifetime's work. What we end up with, only time can tell.
As long as no new fools come around and start ruining things, I'm sure we can keep things in order.
Untie me, you wretched cretin! I demand to be released!
I'm afraid I can't do that, sir, but if you just allow me to...
Word from Candle Hill. Seems the plants are growing there, too. Apparently, a big stem of some kind has pierced right through the canteen. Get some rest, folks. Then we have work to do.